I've seen a tweet from a popular gentleman on Twitter called Gabriel Oguda, whereby he has posted a publicized letter from the Office of the Director of Public Prosecutions, and this letter has allegedly ordered for the arrest of South Mugirango MP Awan Silvanus Osoro. Just allow me to read it for you, and I quote. In his tweet, he says, "Breaking news, South Mugirango MP Silvanus Osoro to be charged with attempted murder of Kisii Governor Simba Arati, the DPP orders." On to the letter. You can see the emblem of the office of the DPP, the DPP statement on investigations into the allegation of attempted murder and related offences in South Mugirango, Kisii County. Number 1. On 22nd November 2023, the DPP received an inquiry file with the outcome on the following investigations implicating the Honorable Silvanus Osoro on the alleged offence of creating disturbance in a manner likely to cause a breach of the people and creating disturbance, allegedly committed during a funeral ceremony at Nyakembene, Boikanga Ward, South Mugirango Constituency. Number 2, on 12th January 2024, the office received a further inquiry file from the DCI with the outcome of the investigations pointing at culpability of the Honorable Silvanus Osoro, MP South Mugirango, and 3 police officers for the offences of attempted murder, assault causing bodily harm, malicious damage to property, and creating disturbance during a bursary function presided over by the Governor of Kisii County on 8th January 2024. Number 3, after independent and in-depth review of the evidence presented, I find that there is abundant evidence to sustain criminal charges against the said Member of Parliament and police officers named therein. Number 4, I have directed that the said Honorable Silvanus Osoro, MP South Mugirango, and the following police officers, PC Kevin Langat, with his number, PC Simon Mureithi, and PC Peter Muge, with the following offences. Number 1, attempted murder. 2, assault causing bodily harm. 3, malicious damage to property. 4, creating disturbance in a manner likely to cause breach of peace contrary to section yada yada. Number 5, I have given consent to DCA to have the suspects arraigned in court to answer to the charges. Apparently, this letter was drafted on the 16th of January 2024, which is yesterday if you're watching it today on the 17th. Now, here's the shocking thing about all this. That letter that I've just read for you is a fictitious letter that was drafted by somebody somewhere and circulated on the internet yesterday. The official Twitter account of the Office of the Director of Public Prosecutions has come out with a tweet that is before you right now, and you can see a legible stamp right there reading fake. So Osoro will not be arrested at any given point because an arrest warrant was never even issued to begin with. Now, there has to be some repercussion for the people who propagate fake news. You know, it's one thing to be misled. If somebody came across that letter and retweeted it or shared it elsewhere, as I've shared it with you, you can't really be culpable because you're also part of the people who've been misled by someone fictitious and malicious. But the DCI needs to track this letter, find out who was the first person to publicize it, and have that person arrested. That is the person who needs to be put behind bars first and foremost. Because these types of letters are usually drafted for purposes of character assassination. Now, either way, assuming this letter was true, is Osoro worthy of an arrest? That's what I want us to look into in today's video. But before we do that, if you're here for the first time, please go on and hit the subscribe button. And if you're watching from a different platform, just head on over to YouTube, search for David Wafula, hit the subscribe button, and you're going to be getting a ton of content of this nature. If politics is something you're passionate about, this is definitely the one channel that you really, really need to subscribe to. So is Osoro eligible for an arrest? Unfortunately, based on the laws of Kenya, he isn't. Arati claims Osoro sent police to clobber him and disrupt his functions. But in reality, the way politicians play this game, they call the area OCS and ask for favors. So the order actually comes from the area OCS, not Osoro. I'm not defending him at all if this is what he's doing, but any misuse of police tracks back to the OCS and not the area MP. Legally, he has zero authority over them. So the real calls should be a reshuffle of the area OCS. But getting Osoro arrested for what the police did is going to be very, very difficult. Second reason why Osoro can't be arrested, he's the Kisii who inherited Matiang'i. Matiang'i was the deep state. He could arrest people left, right, center and get away with it. And in Ruto's government, Osoro is the Kisii who inherited Matiang'i's boots. As we speak, Mashogu is not the senior most Kisii in politics. It is Osoro, then Arati, and Mashogu coming in at a distant third despite being the cabinet secretary of education. So for me, I feel that the weight rests with the OCS. You are in charge of all the police in that area. If they are misbehaving, it is because you have ordered them to. No MP can come and tell police, go do XYZ. They first have to talk to the boss will organize and authorize because the vehicles have to get them there. They have to be given the tear gas with authority. So such is the case. Let's put the blame where it truly is. If we change the area OCS of that region of South Mugirango, I think there'll be peace in the region if at all the OCS and the police are using brute force. But getting Osoro arrested through fictitious letters or even through the legal system, it's impossible because he is not in charge of those police. He's in charge of the constituents of South Mogirango. But either way, guys, that's just my opinion. Do let me know your own comments in the comment section below if you believe Osoro should be put behind bars as that fictitious letter is suggesting, or if you think the blame falls on the OCS, or if there's even any blame to begin with. I'd really love to read your comments and to give you a response. And in the event you're here for the first time, please go on and hit the subscribe button. And if you're watching from a different platform, just head on over to YouTube, search for David Wafula, hit the subscribe button. You're going to be getting a ton of content of this nature. If politics is something you're passionate about, this is definitely the one channel that you really, really need to subscribe to. All right, guys. Adios. Thank you for choosing David Wafula as your primary news platform. We put countless hours in research, recording, and editing. By showing up each and every day to watch our videos, you encourage us to generate more videos for the viewers. We are on a mission to inform, educate, and build a better tomorrow. To our thousands of followers in a world full of presidents, kings, and queens, you are the real gem. Adios.